Hello guys, in this video we are going to solve the paper 2 in Computer Science IGCSE. It is Problem Solving and Programming. The paper code is 0478, the component is 22, the series is May-June and the year is 2019. Before we start solving this paper, if you are new to this channel is all about educative stuff. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon, so that you get instant notification when we upload a video. The first question in section B is, an algorithm has been written in pseudocode to input 100 numbers. Select and print the largest number and smallest number. Find the four errors in the pseudocode and suggest a correction for each error. This is a 4-mark question. These type of question always come in your paper. So, practice some of these questions. Pause this video to read the code. Now let's move on to the errors. The first error is in line number 4. It says, the count value is assigned to the variable low. But the corrected one should be the number value is assigned to the variable low. The second error is in line number 11. It says if number is greater than low, then. But if number is greater than low, all highest value would be recorded. So the corrected value or the corrected code should be if number is less than low, then number value is given to the low variable. The third error is in line number 1. It says the value 1 is equal to count. But here, since they ask input 100 numbers, it should be count is equal to 0, so that here you can write until count is greater than 99. So that 100 inputs can be recorded. The last error in this code is in the 17th line of the code. It says print largest number is comma number, but here the number would be the input number which user gives at the last. So the corrected code would be print largest number is comma high. High is the value or the variable which has the value of the highest number out of the 100 inputs the user has given. Now this is the end of the first subdivision. Now let's move on to the second subdivision. Show how you would change the corrected algorithm to total the numbers and print the total. Use a variable total. Since they have told us to use a variable total, we have to declare the variable total. So the code would be count is equal to 1, input number, high is equal to number, low is equal to number, total is equal to number. Then there is a loop which is repeat input number. Then here total would be total plus number. At first the total value would be 0. So if the user gives the value of number as 1, total would be 0 plus 1 and it would be 1 and stored as the value for total. The next time the user gives input, it would be 1 plus the number he gives. Suppose if it is 5, it would be 1 plus 5 which is equal to 6, and this 6 gets stored to the total value here. Then if number is greater than high, then high is the number. End if. If number is less than low, then low is equal to number. End if. Count is equal to count plus 1 until count is greater than 99. At last you have to write print largest number is high, print large smallest number is low, print total is total. The words which are written here is not actually words. It is the variable which are storing the value of the numbers which are the highest value, the lowest value and the total of all the inputs. I hope you understand this subdivision. Let's move on to the next question. The next question in section B is, this flowchart inputs the mark gained in an examination. An input of -1 ends the routine. Complete the trace table for the mark input data 50, 70, 65, 30, 95, 50, 55, 85, 65, 35, minus 1 and 45. So the flowchart is start, total is assigned as 0, count is also given as 0, distinction is also given as 0. Then input mark, then S mark is equal to minus 1. If yes, output number of distinctions, comma distinction. Output average mark, which is total divided by count. If mark is not equal to minus 1, is mark greater than or equal to 80? If yes, distinction is distinction plus 1. If no, total is equal to total plus mark, count is equal to count plus 1. Then this loop repeats. Now let's complete the trace table. At first you have to write total is equal to 0, count is equal to 0, distinction is equal to 0. Then the first input data is 50. Now let's trace using the flowchart here. Is mark is equal to minus 1? No. Is mark greater than or equal to 80? 50 is not greater than or equal to 80. So total is equal to total plus mark and count is equal to count plus 1. So here the total value would be 50, count value would be 1, distinction value will remain as 0. The next input is 70. 70 is also not greater than 80 or not equal to minus 1. So 70 plus 50 would be 120. The count value gets incremented, so it is 2. Distinction would still remain 0. The next mark is 65. 65 is also not equal to minus 1 and is not greater than or equal to 80. So 120 plus 65 is 185 and the count value gets incremented. The distinction remains 0. The fourth input is 30. 30 is not equal to minus 1. It is not greater than or equal to 80. So 30 plus 185 is 215 and the count value gets incremented. So 3 plus 1, which is 4, the distinction remains 0. The fifth input is 95. Although this is not equal to minus 1, this is greater than 80. So it would be distinction is equal to distinction plus 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. Then the count value also gets incremented. So 4 plus 1 is 5. Then the total also gets summed. So 215 plus 95 is 310. The next input is 50. It is not greater than or equal to 80. So it would be 310 plus 50, which is 360. The count value gets incremented, which is 6. And the distinction is not 0, it is 1. The next input is 55. 55 is not greater than or equal to 80. So 55 plus 360 is 415 and count value is incremented by 1, which is 7. The distinction remains as 1. The next input is 85. It is greater than or equal to 80. So 85 is a distinction mark. So distinction is incremented by 1. So it is 1 plus 1, which is 2. And the count value also gets incremented. So 7 plus 1, which is 8. Then the total also gets summed. So 415 plus 85 is 500. The next input is 65. It is not greater than 80. So 500 plus 65 is 565. The count value gets incremented 8 plus 1, which is 9. The distinction remains same, which is 2. The next mark is 35. 35 plus 565 is 600. The count value gets incremented, which is 10. And the distinction remains 2. The next input is minus 1. Here they have mentioned if mark is equal to minus 1 and it is yes, since the input is minus 1. So we have to output number of distinctions, comma distinction, that is the variable used to store the distinction, comma output average mark, which is total by count. So the output would be number of distinctions, which is 2, which is the last thing which we have wrote here. Then the average mark is total divided by count. The total is 600, the count is 10. 600 divided by 10 is an easy calculation and the average mark is 60. This is an easy 4-mark question which everyone can achieve. I hope you understand this question. Let's move on to the next question. Question is, for each of the 4 groups of statements in the table, place a tick in the correct column to show whether it is an example of selection or repetition. The statement is, for A is equal to 1 to 100, B is B plus 1 and next A. This uses a for to next loop. So this is definitely a repetition. The next statement is, case A of 100, which is B, is equal to A. If case A of 200, C is equal to A. In case, this is a statement which uses selection. That states, if the value of A is 100, the value of A is assigned to the variable B. If it is 200, the value of A is assigned to C. So it is a selection. The next statement is, if A is greater than 100, then B is equal to A. End of. This is simple pseudocode and this is also a selection. The last statement here is, repeat A is B multiplied by 10 until A is greater than 100. This uses a repeat until loop and it also says A is greater than 100. That is until A is greater than 100. So this repeats. So this is a repetition. I hope you understand this question. Now let's move on to the next question. It was an easy 4-mark question, I guess. The next question is, explain what is meant by validation and verification. Give an example for each one. This is the most repeating question in paper 2 of Computer Science IGCSE. I would recommend you to by heart all the 3 points which I have mentioned for validation and verification so that it would be useful whenever they ask you this question. So validation is an automated checking which checks that data is reasonable or not and checks that data meets some certain criteria. Examples are length check, range check, type check, present checks, etc. So length check checks that if the data is in correct length. Type check checks that if the data is in certain type. Suppose you need to set a password and it asks one capital letter, one special letter, and then multiple lowercase letter. It checks whether the input is of the certain type. Present check checks that if the data is entered or not. Now moving on to the next thing, verification. Verification is checking that data has not changed during input to a computer or during transfer between computers. Example is double entry or visual check. Visual check is also manual check which you check by your eyes. This is an easy 6-mark question and is the most repeated one. So make sure you understand this concept very well. Now we have come to the end of the video, that is the last question of section B and the last question of the paper. A database table, flight, is used to keep a record of flights from a small airfield. Planes can carry passengers, freight or both. Some flights are marked as private and only carry passengers. State the field that could have used Boolean data type. Boolean data type is yes or no, which is also written as Y and N. So the field passengers only use the Boolean data type. So the answer is passengers. The next subdivision is, a query by example has been written to display just the flight numbers of all planes leaving after 10 that only carry passengers. So there are 3 criteria mentioned in the question, that is just the flight numbers, after 10 and only carry passengers. I hope you understand this question. Now let's check what is the answer. So explain why query by example is incorrect and write a correct query by example. So the errors in this query by example table is, they have ticked the column for show in passengers, but here in the question they have asked to display just the flight number. So flight number is not displayed, instead passengers number is displayed when it is not to be told so. And the next error is, departure time is set to equal to 10, but here they have asked after 10. So this is a mistake here. It should be greater than 10. And since it is equal to 10, using this data, you can write an answer. A departure time which has 10 has a plane which carries both freight and passengers. So this data would not be excluded which should be excluded. So this is a mistake here. Now let's write the query by example with no mistake. So the field name which you would write are flight name, passengers, departure time and notes. Since I told you there is a plane which is traveling at sharp 10. So the table for this field is flight. This you can write for all the field names. Since they have asked only to display flight number, tick the column for show. Then for passengers, it should be Y, which represents yes. The departure time should be greater than 10 and the note should be not equal to freight and passengers. This is a 7 mark question. I hope you understand this question. That is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, guys. More videos are coming soon, so stay tuned on Code 4. Keep supporting us by subscribing our channel and sharing our valuable videos to your friends.